today I'm going to talk about a very famous Mexican dish. So by show of hands, how many of you have heard or tasted mole? Awesome. Okay. Well, this right here that I brought, this container is mole, and I'm sure you guys have seen it. It's too thick today. We're going to learn a little bit about its history, what it represents in my culture, and how I identify with this culture. I will talk about we're going to learn a bit about the culture behind, like what it represents to me. So it's pretty much is thought of as representing the heart of the Mexican culture. And its creativity in creating such a dish. Mole is, it comes from the Aztec word mole, which means sauce. It's pretty much a thick chocolate tinged sauce. A lot of people add chocolate to it. It depends from person to person, state to state in Mexico. Also, pretty much was invented. Well, the legend goes that it was invented by nuns in a convent in Puebla, Mexico. And they pretty much, they learned that the archbishop was gonna come and visit them. They panicked because they didn't know what to cook for the archbishop. So they just started gathering whatever ingredients they had, like day-old bread, nuts, chocolate, and a plethora of other ingredients. So they mixed it, they boiled it for hours until it reached this thick, sweet aroma we are familiar today. So much to the surprise, the archbishop really loved it, and that's how the mole was born. Back in the colonial times in Mexico in the 16th century. It has a lot of ingredients, like I just said, nuts, chocolate. It has cilantro seeds. Even burnt tortillas, so my mom adds to it. She burns the tortillas like until they're pretty much black, and she crushes them. They grind them, they roast the stuff, and it's a very time-consuming process. So that's why it's only done during very special occasions, like quinceañeras, weddings, baptisms, birthday parties, even in first communion parties we tend to do in our family. And pretty much, it also represents the Mexican culture so much that the LA mayor this past Friday declared Mole Day. And this Sunday they had a festival of mole where the best mole makers go to Olvera Street and they show their mole in various in color, like red, brown, black, green, yellow, depending on where you go in Mexico. And this, I can identify a lot with this culture because whenever there's weddings in a family, we always expect this dish, along with rice, beans, tamales, and tortillas with it. And my mother also makes this mole from scratch, because nowadays you could buy it from the store already made in a glass container. But she makes it, and it's been passed on from generation to generation, and each generation can add their own spice to it. I haven't learned how to make it yet, but I do help her roast some stuff, and it's a very, very long time, so I guess that's why I'm lazy to learn it. But it really brings us together as a family whenever there's like this big event. We really enjoy eating this dish with our loved ones. And so today we learned a little bit about its history, how I identify with it, and whenever you, I'm pretty sure since most of you already had this dish, I'm pretty sure you guys know whenever you eat this you need plenty of napkins because you really get dirty with it.